hello, and hello to my show, The Matthew Hall Show. Yes, this is my hat-trick show, as it were. Welcome to PulseTVHD. Yes, PulseTV has gone high definition, so you can really see what my face actually looks like. So this month, Comic Relief raised £74 million. The fundraising efforts included a 52-hour-long radio show marathon by radio DJ Chris Moyles. So those who hate him really could listen to him in his sleep. Colonel Gaddafi's stubborn leadership over Libya continues. But don't worry, people of the world, the United Nations have told him off for being a naughty boy. The 2012 Olympics countdown clock spectacularly failed less than 24 hours after being switched on. Ah, the signs of disaster are coming already. Now, a more observant view will have noticed a small P in that corner of the screen in the opening credits. If you didn't see it, go back and have a look now. The joys of YouTube. Anyway, this is the symbol that all TV shows which must now place at the start of every programme on British television if it contains product placement. So a verbal warning to you all now, this programme contains product placement. Anyway, in other entertainment news, it appears that JLS are copying Justin Bieber and are going to make a film about themselves and their careers so far. These are adamant, unconfirmed reports. Questions this throws up. Will Matt Damon play Simon Cowell? Will Kylie Minogue play Danny Minogue? And how many millions of pounds will the X Factor voiceover get for appearing in the film? Or being listened to in the film? You know what I mean. I hope that if this movie does happen, they really over-dramatise it, such as a longer silence in the X Factor final before the result is announced, and really over-dramatised reactions, like, no! No, you get the idea. The amount of time that adverts will have to be broadcast on British TV channels has gone from 7 minutes an hour to 12 minutes per hour. To put that into perspective, I could get away with having 3 minutes of this show taken up by adverts. Actually, see you after the break.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Where was I? Ah, yes. So, to put it in another perspective, for an hour of film on ITV, The Bright Side, you could now have 48 minutes of film and 12 minutes of adverts. So basically, you'll get even more annoyed at the amount of adverts that are on television. As if some advertising on television was not bad enough. As if most films weren't ruined enough by adverts at the moment. Look. I am your WeBuyAnyCar.com. 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 Any. WeBuyAnyCar. I got carried away there. Cut it. We can cut that bit out.
Ready, go!
Well, the 2012 Olympics, greatest tickets on earth, have officially gone on sale this month. Hooray! In fact, I've actually ordered some dirt cheap tickets for the London 2012 Olympics opening ceremony at £20.12. In fact, I received a letter this morning that I believe is my tickets. I haven't opened it yet. I'll go leave it to the show. So now we're in the show. Let's have a quick look, shall we? Dear Mr. Hall, we are pleased to inform you that you have been successful in obtaining tickets to the London 2012 Olympics opening ceremony. Get in! Yeah! We have taken £2,012 out of your bank account and your what? Damn, must put the decimal point in the wrong place. Now I have a good ticket, but I'm completely and utterly skint. Are you in this situation? Visit your local Lloyds TSB bank. Bad news for speed fans in Australia this month. Australian town changes name to Speed Kills. Yes, this is the terrible, and let's be quite honest, humorous news, that the town Speed in Australia has changed its name to Speed Kills. When asked for comment, Jeremy Clarkson was livid. Look at the reason why. 10,000 Facebook users supported renaming Speed to Speed Kills. The change would go ahead in return for a donation to local charity. In the end, over 30,000 Facebook users supported the campaign. Take a look at this town's new welcome sign. You have to admit, that's the most modern welcome sign you've ever seen to a town, isn't it? I would love to see similar signs put up around towns all around Britain. Talking of which, imagine what would happen if similar campaigns took place here in Britain. Campaigns for Reading to change its name to Note-Taking, and getting the town of Barking to change its name to Sit. Now it's time for your favourite part of the show. Probably. Yes, it's time for the Facebook. I still don't have a button, but I'm going to conveniently use this Coca-Cola can as a sort of button. Anyway, you have 20 seconds to update and check your Facebook status, starting from now. Everyone, major historical news from Scotland this month, as the Loch Ness Monster has been spotted again. Ah, you're all thinking the mystery is finally solved. Well, you'd be wrong. Typically, this story is flawed with many problems. Typically, the monster was spotted by two IT workers on a kayaking trip for a group bonding activity. Now, if there's three things that shouldn't go together in the same sentence, it's IT workers, kayaking, and group bonding activity. And then there's the typically rubbish picture of the sighting itself. Take a look at this picture. How utterly unconvincing is that photograph? They could have faked that with Photoshop or on a pond on a misty morning. Of course, local hotel owners are now looking forward to a busy summer of Loch Ness Monster spotters staying in their hotels. Or as they really should be called, nutters. Or primeval facts. ITV, the brightest. That's what I go to school for. The wind is real. Okay, time for some more Hagley High news. Last time I had this item on the show, I reviewed Hagley's new magazine, Hearsay. Well, this show was actually mentioned in the second issue, along with an article written by myself about PulseTV. The second issue sold out within 3 days, over 200 copies sold. So it appears my review must have gone down very well, and it is remarkable how well this is selling. It's definitely very popular reading with students. And there'll be another issue out, apparently just after Easter, so get ready to grab those copies while you can. Elsewhere, the Great Library Quiz ran for its 16th consecutive year this month, with the winners being last year's reigning champions, George White and Richard Tudor, who would appropriately call themselves Team Reigning Champions. They now join the many great names that are on the GLQ Roll of Honour in the library. Finally, PulseTV's sort of sister organisation, Pulse Radio, is making a comeback. Yes! It's been nearly 2 years since the last show came out, and has been made by young entertainer Dan Davis, who is fast becoming a PulseTV and Pulse Radio star. The link to the show can be found in the description below here on YouTube. Alternatively, you can just search Pulse Radio, The Sunny Side Up Show on YouTube. With lots of great reviews and good music, this show is well worth a listen to. So, well done to Dan Davis. end of each show, I give you all a picture to look at, and you can post captions to it as comments on this video. Then I decide the best winner by the end of the month, and I mention them in the next show. You know the routine by now. We are on show 3 after all. So last month saw a much tighter contest than we did in February. So I can announce that the winner of the last capturing competition on the Matthew Hall Show is Marco of the Funk, with this caption to this picture. So this month, here is your new picture to post some captions to. So get posting some good captions, ladies and gentlemen, especially as you'll have longer for this one, as I unfortunately have to announce that there will not be a Matthew Hall Show at the end of April. Unfortunately, I'm away from home a lot over the next month, and I'm rather busy, so I'm not going to have time to make another show. But there will be one in May, although possibly earlier than I would normally do it. So keep an eye on the Pulse TV website on that one. However, do not despair, as my fellow Pulse TV presenters and Pulse Radio presenters, well, I'm sure keep you entertained while I'm not on your YouTube screens, or on your computer screens, technically. But anyway, yes, keep checking the Pulse TV website for further updates on this. Also, I hope that soon I will be recording a show called Ashley Dunn's Top 10 Moments. Loyal Pulse TV viewers will remember Ashley Dunn as a regular Pulse TV presenter up until last Christmas. So this is very much a tribute show that I will be recording, where people have voted for his top 10 moments on Pulse TV. So, plenty to look forward to, even though there won't be another Matthew Hall show until May. Now, before we finish the show, I want to briefly say a few words about the terrible things that have happened in Japan in the earthquake and tsunami. Now, I do normally script this show, but I haven't written anything for this short bit at the end because I want to say this literally off the tip of my tongue. We saw all the terrible things that have happened in Japan, and it really touched many people. The first time ever we saw a tsunami unfold live on television. It was really heartbreaking, and the destruction caused is unbelievable. The amount of people killed is staggering, and the rescue effort is unbelievable. We all think of our problems in everyday life, but a disaster like this really does put it into perspective. For example, that day I had trouble getting into sixth form because there weren't any trains running, because all the London Midland drivers were on strike. But as soon as something like this happens, it just doesn't make it matter anymore that you've missed a train to your place of work for the day. All I can say is good luck to the people of Japan, and I wish all of you a speedy recovery from this disaster, which has struck many millions of lives, not only in Japan, but around the world. I hope you've enjoyed the show. Goodbye.